This might be easy, and maybe I'm just confused. Well, let's take a look. Here we are talking about the limit as x approaching 0 of x times sine of 1 over x. So what do? Like always, let's go ahead and plug in 0 into all the x's first, right? This number into all the x's. When we do that, we'll get 0 times sine of 1 over 0. And can we draw conclusions along the way? Check this out. 0 is 0, sine is sine. And for the inside, 1 over 0, if this is a 0 plus, we will get infinity. So technically, we may have to consider plus or minus, right? Both directions, because originally it's just 0. By the way, though, here's the point. If you see we have sine of infinity, in terms of a limit, what do we do? In fact, this right here is DNE, meaning does not exist. Why? Because if you take a look at the limit as x approaching infinity of the sine function, and if you look at the curve, it goes like this, right? That's the sine curve. You see that it does not have any horizontal asymptote. So the limit as x approaching infinity of sine function, this right here does not exist. All right. So now the question is, we have DNE here. Does that mean the whole thing is DNE? Or maybe we have 0 times DNE, so it should be 0. Well, the truth is we have to observe more and present a legitimate solution, and we cannot just say 0 times anything is equal to 0. That's not true when we're talking about limits. When you have 0 times infinity, well, we will have to do a lot more work for that, so cannot say anything right away. One thing to notice though, right here, we cannot use L'Hopital's rule, no L'Hopital's rule, because this limit here, it's not in the 0 over 0 form or infinity over infinity form, and we cannot get them into this form, so no L'Hopital's rule here. So for this question, when we have sine, this is what we can use. Note, we know that when we have a sine function, let's say we have a sine theta, this right here is always in between of negative 1 and 1, because that's the range of the sine function. And this right here is for all theta, right? So you can see that this graph shows you the sine function has to be in between of negative 1 and 1. So since this is for all theta, we can put 1 over x into theta, and this is still true. So if you look at sine of 1 over x, this right here will still give you in between of negative 1 and 1. Perfect. Now you see, this is kind of like what we have, but we just need to have the x right here, right? So from this equation, let's multiply everybody by x. But you have to be careful a little bit though, because x can be negative or it can be positive. So let's say this right here is for x greater than 0. Okay, let's say we are multiplying everything by positive. Why not equal to? Because remember, when we have x is approaching 0, we don't need x is exactly 0. So if x is greater than 0, then we can maintain the inequality. We get negative x less than or equal to x times sine of 1 over x, and then less than or equal to x. So that's the key. This is why I said x is greater than 0, so we can maintain these two inequalities. If x is less than 0, you just have to flip the inequalities. Alright, so if we look at this, we can then take the limit. So this right here gives you, I'm going to write this down for you. I will say, if we take a look at the limit as x approaching 0, plus, because as I said, this is x greater than 0, so x plus. X is approaching 0 plus. So when we do this, like that, this right here will be less than or equal to the limit as x approaching 0 plus, and we have x sine of 1 over x. And then, of course, one more, less than or equal to, and then we have the limit as x approaching 0 plus, and here we have x. have a look. Can we figure out this right here? Yes, because if you can just put 0 plus into here, negative 0 is just 0, negative 0 plus just 0. So this right here is just 0. Likewise, this right here is also just 0. So you can see the limit that we have in the middle, x approaching 0 plus of x sine of 1 over x. This limit is in between of 0 and 0 with the equal sign. So that means, right, this means, I'll just put this down, this means that the limit as x approaching 0 plus of x sine of 1 over x, this must be equal to 0. And I will say this is by the powerful squeeze theorem. Cool. And now we will also have to do the other side, right? Because as I said, originally, this is just 0. So we had to talk about 0 plus and also 0 minus. But for the 0 minus, it's very, very straightforward. So I will say this is part 1 and then part 2 right here. There we go. We know that sine of 1 over x, this has to be in between of negative 1 and 1. And I'm going to multiply everybody by x, but this time is for x less than 0. So in this case, we will get negative x, but we will have to flip the inequalities. And then we have x sine of 1 over x, and then flip the inequalities right here, and then we have x. And then we take the limit as x approaching 0 minus. Cool. Now, same thing. This is 0. Likewise, this is also clearly to be 0. And then maintain the inequalities. And then the limit in between. So, as you can see, we can draw a conclusion that the limit as x approaching 0 minus of x sine of 1 over x, this has to be equal to 0. So, finally, we can say by 1 and 2, we conclude that the limit as x approaching 0 of x times sine of 1 over x, this is indeed equal to 0.